this is a new beginning in the city of Kochi, in the state of Kerala, when we are celebrating the holy 131st birth anniversary of our Premamaya Sree Sree Thakur in Kochi. In the very recent past, Kerala saw devastating floods destroying thousands of lives. And today we have assembled here to celebrate the life force, which is the cause of life, which can bring life, which can generate life. And we are here to celebrate this life force. Today's topic is the ideology and philosophy of Parampremaya Sree Sree Thakur, Thakur Anukul Chandra for the mankind. So what is the philosophy or ideology of Sree Sree Thakur Anukul Chandra? What is its relevance for the mankind? Sree Sree Thakur Anukul Chandra's mission was that of man-making and man-remaking. My beloved Dada, Sri Palda, was saying Sree Sree Thakur's mission is that of man-making. So, what is this mission of man-making all about? When Deshbandhu Chittaranjan Das came to Sree Sree Thakur, when the independence movement was going on in full swing, and after spending a few days with Sree Sree Thakur, he wanted to go back to the freedom movement. Sree Sree Thakur asked him, "Dasda, can you not stay back for a few days?" Chittaranjan Das said, "I want to, Thakur. I want to stay back for some more days, but I cannot. The freedom movement is going on in full swing. There is not a single person on whom I can depend even for a single day. Thakur, I have to go back." Thakur became grave. He looked pale. His face looked pale. He looked sad. And he said, "Dasda, you do not have a single human being who can carry the freedom movement for a single day. The freedom movement which is coming, the independence which is coming, the liberty which is coming, who is going to carry that? You don't have a single man today who can carry the freedom movement for a single day. Who is going to carry the freedom? Who is going to shoulder the responsibility of independence? Who is going to shoulder that responsibility? Create human beings. Create good human beings. Create good individuals. If you really want a good society, if you really want a good nation, if you want to really want to have a good province, create good human beings." That was the mission of Sree Sree Thakur Anukul Chandra, the mission of man-making and man-remaking. So how is this man-making possible? How is this man-making possible? How can we transform human beings in this society? How can we create good individuals, good people who can bring good values to our nation? How is that possible? Sree Sree Thakur answered that question in a very simple manner. When an American devotee came to the ashram and asked Sree Sree Thakur, he was a very famous personality in the United States of America, the vice president of Harper Brothers Publication House. He was an extremely busy businessman, a business tycoon. He came to Sree Sree Thakur, asked one question. He said, "Thakur, I'm an extremely busy businessman. I do not have time to listen to your ideology. Can you explain your ideology to me in simply two words? Just in two words, please." Sree Sree Thakur smiled, paused for a moment, and said, "Mr. X-Man, be concentric. Be concentric. Be with the center. Have a center in your life." X-Man asked Thakur, "Be concentric around who?" Sree Sree Thakur said, "Be concentric around your living idea. Around your living idea." X-Men asked, "Oh, be concentric around my living idea. So what happens if Henry Ford becomes my living idea? The most famous industrialist, businessman in America. What happens if he becomes my living idea?" Sree Sree Thakur replied, saying, if Henry Ford becomes your living idol, then you can probably become another Henry Ford, but you cannot become a Jesus Christ. You can become a Henry Ford, but you cannot become Jesus Christ. The higher is your ideal, the higher is your life. The more elevated is your ideal, the more elevated is your life. So, the living ideal, if the living ideal is the supreme fulfiller, if he is the creator, if he is the causative factor, and who is the fulfiller the best, who is the most reformed personality, the most transformed personality, the most evolved personality in this world, if you have him at the center of your life, then your life would be the most balanced, the most fulfilling, the most transformed, the most beautiful, the most amazing, if you have the supreme fulfiller as the living ideal in your life. So Sree Sree Thakur says, spirituality is not about scriptures. Spirituality is not about ideology. Spirituality is not about an ism. Because Thakur says, by reading Ramayana, nobody's character has become transformed. By reading Quran, nobody's personality has been transformed. By reading Bible, nobody's personality has been transformed. But following Lord Rama, following Lord Krishna, following Lord Jesus Christ, following Lord Muhammad Rasul, people's life has been transformed. That's why there is a need for a living ideal, somebody who has materialized Ramayana in him, somebody who has materialized Gita in him, somebody who has materialized Quran in his life. If you have such a personality at the center of our life, then the life is fulfilled, then his life is transformed. The famous Nobel laureate Alexis Carrel says that man cannot enthusiastically follow the rational conduct of life unless he considers the law of life as the commands of a personal God. Very clearly he is saying, man really cannot follow the Bible, man cannot really follow Gita, man cannot really follow the rational conduct, the rational policies of good conduct or good behavior or good personality, unless he believes that the law of life is the command of a personal God. Who is that personal God? That personal God is a living ideal, who has materialized, you know, all the best in him, who is the fulfiller of the best. And that's why Sree Sree Thakur is saying that man today needs a God whom he can see, whom he can touch, whom he can talk to, whom he can interact with, engage in a dialogue, ask questions, ask queries. We need such a personality, such a living idea that we can talk to, that we can listen to, that we can engage in a dialogue. And such a personality is a living idea. And that such personality is the creator of the mankind. A very famous professor of Kolkata University, Mr. Panchanand Sarkar, he met one of the devotees of Thakur, Anant Narayan. They had a chance meeting in a train, and a conversation broke out between the two. And Anant Narayan talked about his guru, his living ideal, Sree Sree Thakur and Panchanand. And Panchanand Sarkar interrupted him. He said, Anant Narayan, don't you think that man has some intelligence? Anant Narayan said, yes. Then Panchanand Sarkar asked him, don't you think that God is omnipresent? Anant Narayan said, yes, God is omnipresent. Then he said, why do you have to talk about your guru? Why do you have to talk about your spiritual guide? God is everywhere. Man is intelligent. Man has some experience. Man has some knowledge. Man has some wisdom. And can't that man with his knowledge and with wisdom try and understand the spiritual guide or the guru or the God? Why do you have to go and evangelize him? Why do you have to go and preach him? Why do you have to go and talk about him? Anant Narayan politely looked at Panchanand Sarkar and asked, Dada, what do you do? He said, that's not important. Answer my question. Anant Narayan said, I cannot answer your question, but you seem to be a great man. Tell me who you are. Panchanan Sarkar, I am the professor of an university, Kolkata University. I have done masters in two subjects. I have done my doctorate in mathematics. I teach mathematics in the university, in Kolkata University. Anant Narayan asked, Dada, does your university have a syllabus? He said, yes. The government of Kolkata, West Bengal, has prescribed the syllabus. And Anant Narayan is asking Panchanan Sarkar, Dada, are the books available everywhere as per the syllabus? He said, in every bookstall in the state of Bengal, wherever you go, you will find those prescribed books everywhere. So Anant Narayan is asking, Dada, don't you think that your students have some intelligence, some knowledge, some wisdom? He said, yes, they are good students. They have some knowledge, some wisdom, some intelligence. He said, Dada, what are you doing there? He said, I am teaching mathematics. He said, Dada, but why? Why are you there teaching mathematics? The syllabus has been prescribed. Books are available in every bookstore. Students already have some intelligence, some knowledge. Can't they read the books? Can't they read the syllabus? Can't they follow the curriculum? Do they need a teacher like you, Panchanan Sarkarji? Panchanan Sarkar said, but to teach mathematics, you need a teacher. To understand mathematics, you need a teacher. Anant Narayan said, Dada, but do you think this life is so insignificant? This life is so meaningless? This life is so trivial? That to understand life, we don't need a life teacher. Don't we need a life teacher? If to learn, understand mathematics, you need a mathematics teacher. To understand life, don't you need a life teacher, Panchanan Sarkar? Panchanan Sarkar lost all his arrogance. He had won many battles against many pundits. But he accepted defeat before a normal, ordinary devotee of Sree Sree Thakur. He came to Sree Sree Thakur, accepted Sree Sree Thakur as a living ideal, as his guru, as a spiritual guide, as a spiritual master. What happens when we accept a living ideal or a guru? What happens? We all understand. We talked about the importance, the relevance of having a guru. But when we have a living ideal, and when we love him, when we surrender to him, and when we serve him, all his characteristics slowly become ours. All his characteristics of divinity slowly enter into our personality, our character. So Sree Sree Thakur has said, if you love anybody unconditionally, all his characteristics will become your characteristics. So if you love your living ideal unconditionally, his characteristics can become your characteristics. And that is Thakur is saying, that is Thakuratva. So you can awaken Thakuratva in you. You can awaken divinity in you. You can awaken mastery in you if you surrender to that. So when the living ideal becomes a love center, we gain control over our complexes, our passions. Sree Sree Thakur is saying, all the problems, all the miseries in this world come to us because of our complexes. Our complexes give us thrill. They give us excitement. When you talk about anger, when you talk about lust, when you talk about infatuation, when you talk about jealousy, all this kaam, krodh, mad, love, moh, aashcharya, when we talk about these complexes and passions, they give us a thrill. They give us excitement. Then because of them, we get attracted to them. But through them we invite misery in life, distress in life, sorrow in life. And they become the root cause of all our problems. Thakur is saying, if you really want to have happiness in life, you need to gain control over those complexes, control over these passions. And the best way to control that is to have a love center in your life. To have a love center in your life. If there is a crocodile in the river, and if you want to go and kill that crocodile, you cannot go inside the water and kill it, because the crocodile is extremely powerful inside the water. Inside the water, the crocodile has all the power and strength to defeat you and then probably take control over you. But if you really want to defeat the crocodile, you have to stand outside the river, take the help of a weapon, and then fire at the crocodile, and then you can kill it. Similarly, if you have to kill the complexes in you, you can't go inside yourself and kill them, because the complexes are extremely powerful and dangerous within yourself. if you really want to gain control, you need to take the help of somebody who's superior to you, more elevated than you, more powerful than you, more wise than you, more knowledgeable than you. Who can that person be other than the living ideal? If you take his center, accept him, and then love him with your love and surrender to him, when you go and attempt to take charge over your complexes become your slaves. They will not enslave you anymore. So we need to accept somebody who is superior to us, who is more elevated than us, who is more knowledgeable than us, who knows the clue of living a life, who knows how to live like a son, live like a father, live like a brother, live like a friend, who has lived his life himself. And then we need such a personality as our guru, as our spiritual guide at the center of our life. Then only we can have control of our complexes. And you're saying, when you have passion pervading love for him, passion pervading love, so when my love for him pierces through the passion that I have, then I understand him, then I can realize him in my life. So we need that love which is passion pervading, which can pierce through my complexes, and then I can accept. So Sree Sree Thakur is saying, we are talking about ideology and philosophy, Sree Sree Thakur today, in the context of present mankind. Sree Sree Thakur is talking about three fundamental principles of man-making. Three fundamental principles of man-making. Thakur is saying, Diksha, Shiksha, and Vivaha. Initiation, education, and marriage. When you're talking about man-making, when you're talking about bringing transformation in this society, when you're talking about bringing happiness to the man, a stress-free environment to the man, we need these three things. Initiation to the living ideal, education, and marriage. The first comes initiation. Initiation by the living ideal brings, Sree Thakur is saying, dharma is embedded in the living ideal. And initiation by the living ideal brings adherence. And adherence brings adjustment of complexes. And adjustment of complexes brings uphold of existence. So if you really want to uphold our existence, we need to adjust our complexes. If you want to adjust our complexes, we really have to adhere, have complete adherence and devotion to the living ideal. And if you have complete adherence and love to the living ideal, we need to be initiated by the living ideal. So that's where the importance of initiation and diksha comes.